Hey, good morning. It is December 21st, and it's time for Pastor Rick's Reflections. Today, I'm going to cheat. Yesterday was the commemoration of Katharina von Bora Luther, and I just didn't want to skip her. So even though her commemoration was yesterday, we're going to give her a little attention today. Katharina von Bora Luther was born in Lippendorf, Germany, on January the 29th, 1499. In 1509, she entered a Cistercian convent as a nun. In 1523, on Easter Eve, she left the convent with 11 other nuns. Allegedly, she was smuggled out in a herring barrel, I think is the story. On June 13th, 1525, she married Martin Luther. And during the time of their marriage, she managed the parsonage. She managed boarders that were there, took care of the farm, livestock, gardens, fishery, and the beer brewery. She bore 6 children, 4 of whom survived childhood. And then on December 20th in 1552, she died in Torgau, Germany, 4 years after Luther's death. The woman whom Martin Luther called My Lord Katie managed the family's complex household, which at times resembled a hotel, and its extended farm. Thanks largely to her success, the phenomenon of a married clergy and a socially significant parsonage became the ideal of most Protestants. The story is told that at Luther's marriage, the Archbishop Albrecht of Mainz, who opposed Luther's reforms, sent a wedding gift of 20 guilders. Martin intended to refuse the money, but Katharina, who knew their emerging financial needs, said that the money had come from the Lord, and they must keep it. And they did. And these are Katharina's or Katie's last words. I will cling to Christ like a burr to a dress. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, we thank you for another wonderful day, a day that gives us life and hope from you and love. And we pray that you empower us to share your love with others. As we remember incredible women like Katharina von Bora Luther, we thank you for so many women of faith that have helped us along the way, for pastors and Sunday school teachers, and now in our church, bishops and moms and grandmas and aunts and sisters. We thank you for the witness of women, for supportive and incredible spouses that help us be the people that you are calling us to be. Continue to raise up women who do such marvelous things for the sake of your love. As the numbers of those infected in our area continue to rise in horrible ways, we ask that you watch over us during this pandemic even more. Push us to be smarter, to do things that are that help protect us and our families and our communities, so that we can get this pandemic ended sooner rather than later. Protect those who are in harm's way. Heal our sick. We give you thanks that progress has been made with vaccines, but we pray that we continue to fight the good fight until we have that vaccine given enough to really create immunity. Watch over all those in need. Help us to see where we can be a neighbor to one another. Keep us always in your care and remind us of your love. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.